Earlier, when learning template-driven form, these are the fields we included. Now, when learning reactive form, so far we have implemented only the name input text element. Including email and password fields in reactive form will be similar to how we implemented name input text element so far. Hence, I will not be including email and password fields in the reactive form implementation. You can implement it as an exercise in your reactive form. I will demonstrate implementation of status dropdown, gender radio buttons, and promotions checkbox in my reactive form. In this video, I will demonstrate the implementation of status dropdown list with validation. I have the template-driven form implementation opened in a separate Visual Studio Code window so that I can reuse code whenever required. The first step is to define status data. I am copying status.ts from the template-driven form window and pasting it in the src/app folder of reactive form window. This file contains the definition of a model class for status and creation of an array of status objects. The data in the status objects array is what will be used to display the options in the status dropdown list. To access the status data in component class, I am including statuses as a property of type status array assigned with value as statuses, which represents the status array created in status.ts. This property will help us to populate the list of items for status dropdown list. Next, we need to include a new form control for status dropdown in form group. After the first form control, I am including a comma. In the next line, I am including the property as status, having new form control with constructor having empty string as first parameter and validators.required as second parameter. For a form control constructor, if we are going to apply only one validation, then it can be defined without an array. The form control for status is now defined. Next, we need to include get method for status control so that it can be accessed in the HTML template. I am copying and pasting the existing get function and replacing name with the status. Now we have got the get function completed. For the code in HTML template, I am going to copy and paste the code from template-driven form implementation. I am copying the status part of the code from template-driven form window and pasting it in the reactive form window. The name attribute, required attribute, two-way data binding, template reference variable, model change event, and compare with definition is not required for reactive form, hence removing them. I am including form control name directive with value as status, which refers to the recent form control included in the form group. Then I am going to replace all the instances of status field as status question mark so that it points to the form control object defined in the component class. I am going to make this change using the find and replace feature available in Visual Studio Code. With this, all the necessary changes for including status select element is completed. I am saving both the files. After the page reload, we can see the status dropdown list displayed with the select status option pre-selected. I am going to test the validation for the status select element. I am clicking on status dropdown and then clicking outside without making any selection. We can see that it results in mandatory field error and red outline around the select element. I am clicking on status dropdown and selecting an element. We can see the validation error message is not displayed for the select element. Now I am going to select the select status option. It again results in mandatory field validation error message on the select element. to check if validations work on submit, I am refreshing the browser and then directly clicking on the submit button, we can see the mandatory field validation error message on the select element. Whenever an option is selected in the dropdown, we can see the respective status object getting included in the form data. With all these test scenarios working, we have successfully completed the implementation of select dropdown list in a reactive form. I would like to highlight how the default value of select dropdown gets selected. We already know that whatever value assigned in the first parameter of the form control constructor gets reflected in the field. When we defined the form control object for status, we defined the value of the field in the first constructor parameter as empty string. In the HTML template, we can see that we have included a separate option to display select status. Notice that its value is also empty string. Based on this matching value, the select status option gets selected by default based on the definition of form control name directive. Apart from this, the rest of the features work in a similar way in the HTML template. Based on the instructions provided in this video, complete the inclusion of status select element and check if it works as expected.